So let's take a look at a couple of quick scenarios, and the idea here is I want to see if we can identify whether or not this would be appropriate for a binomial. So Rob Supercola, some new soda, is on the market. He has set up a taste test between Coca-Cola, Pepsi. I'm sorry, Cola, his Cola, Coke, Pepsi, and Sam's Club Cola. His hopes are to gather evidence suggesting his new Cola is preferred over the other three. So, 75 people take the taste test. Can a binomial distribution be used to model the resulting probabilities? Well, let's see. I'm going to do these out of order because sometimes, well, actually, there is no real order to it. The order that I presented them earlier was just because that's the way I wrote it down. So, I'm going to start off with two possibilities. Are there two possible outcomes here? Something that can cause success and a failure. Well, there's one, two, three, there's four different sodas, but that's okay because what are we asking? Do they like Rob's better than the other? So I'm going to say two outcomes. And then say success equals Rob's, failure equals any of the other. So now I have two outcomes. If somebody picked Pepsi, that's not Rob's. That's another. If they pick Coke, that's not Rob's. That's another. If they pick Sam's, that's not Rob's. It's the other. So it's going to be Rob's or one of the others. So there's only two things here. And then I'm going to do probability of success equals, well, what do we know? We'll see, there's one, two, three, there's four of them. So the probability of success, if there's actually no difference between these, would be one fourth. Now think about that for a second. If there's no difference between them, then you expect 25% of the time that somebody's just randomly going to end up picking his cola. Right? So we're going to calculate this as the probability of his soda being chosen is one out of four. So three out of four would be probably a failure. And then I need the n independent identical trials. Well, n is fixed at, I said 75 people at 75. They're independent. Let's say just as an example, if first picked Rob's, don't know what second will do. See, I'm not looking for a dissertation here. Just briefly, what is it you're thinking? How do you know they're independent? They're identical. They're just tasting soda and picking what they like best. That's it. They're just the same thing over and over and over again. They're just tasting all the sodas and saying, I like that one the best. That's how they're too. So here I would say I'm gonna let X, oops. Let X be the number that picked Rob's. So this is a binomial, and we could use a binomial to calculate probabilities. So let's change this scenario just a little bit. Can we use this new scenario, or under the circumstances of this new scenario, could we use it with a binomial? So it's a new soda on the market, has set up a taste test between his cola, Coke, Pepsi, and Sam's Club. His hopes are to gather evidence suggesting his new cola is preferred over the other three. Rob gives a taste test until he has gathered 75 people that prefer his cola. Can a binomial distribution be used to model the resulting probabilities? And the answer here is absolutely no, there's not. And the problem is, N is not fixed. This is a scenario where he's going to keep going until he gets 75 people that say they like his best. Well, what would N be? We don't know. It could be 100. It could be 750. It could be 10,000. Who knows? Who knows how many people he's going to have to go through before he gets 75 that says he likes or they like his best. This first scenario simply said they're going to test 75 people. They're going to randomly grab 75 people. N is fixed. That's it. Now we know N. And then when we're done, we can start figuring out whether or not they really like his soda better than others or not. Now, I want to take this just one step further. Let's just suppose, again, here we already said the N is 75. We said the probability of success pi is 0.25, is 1/4. Let's just suppose that we ended up with 37 that said yes to Rob's. Or they picked Rob's as being the best. Okay, does this mean that his, actually, they liked his better? Or could this simply be randomly by choice or by chance? Well, let's take a look real quick. I have 0, 1, 2. Now, I need to go to 75, but you know what? I'm not going out to 75. Dot, dot, dot. 37 is where all the action happens, so maybe I go 35, 36, 37, 38, dot, 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 out to 75. So I need to start thinking in terms of, was this unusual or not? Well, there's several different ways I can go about it. Okay, first of all, suppose, I want to find mu. Mu equals n times pi, which is 75 times 1/4, which is 18.75. Wow, that's quite a ways. 18.75 compared to this 37, it looks like it's quite a distance away. The standard deviation here, sigma, equals the square root of n times pi times 1 minus pi, which when you put in those values, you're going to get 3.75. Okay, so let's take a look and see how many standard deviations this is away. So I have 37 minus the mean, which is 18.75. That's a distance between what was observed minus the mean. So that's the observed minus mu. That's what that is. Divided by the standard deviation, 3.75. That's going to give me the number of standard deviations that this 37 is away from the mean, which would be expected if all the sodas were essentially the same. And that will give you 4.866666 repeat. So I'm just going to say 4.8667. Doesn't really matter. This 4.8 is really a kicker. Doesn't matter if you're using the empirical rule or Chebyshev's rule. This is almost 5 standard deviations away. That's extremely unusual. Okay, so what does that mean? What it means is that they probably really do like his better. It's not just a matter of random chance. They probably really do like his better. Now let's take another approach to this. We observed 37. I don't really care what the probability of 37 is. More realistically, I want to know what the probability of X being greater than or equal to 37 given N equals 75, pi equals 1/4. Now, when I find this probability in TC stats, what I ended up with is 4.836 E negative 0. Whoops, that's supposed to be a 0. 0.6. This is scientific notation. This is saying this to move the decimal point 6 places negative to the left. So 4.836123456. That's where the decimal goes. And zeros go here. So this probability is more like 0.00000, should be 5 zeros, 4836. This would be the probability that it simply happened by chance. What's the probability that if you give 75 people this taste test and by chance they're going to pick Rob's, given, like I said, 75 of these people doing the taste test? Actually, I think I said that wrong. 75 people doing the taste test and at least 37 picking Rob's. This is incredibly small. This is saying it shouldn't happen, but it did. If it did actually happen, then that's probably because they like Rob's better. So there's two different approaches to answering the same question. First is by looking at the number of standard deviations away, which we'll later identify as being a z-score. That terminology will come up a little bit later. You're just being introduced to it now. And we looked at it with probabilities. The fact that the probability of this occurring is very, very, very small, but it did occur, tells me there's a reason. And the reason is this probability right here is wrong. We use 1/4 as a probability as if they were all equally likely, all four of them. But it appears that it's not true. It looks like the probability of them actually preferring Rob's is closer to 37 out of 75, which is approximately 0.4933. This is empirical. This is an empirical estimate for what the true probability is that some randomly person would pick Rob's versus those other three sodas. So this idea of the 1/4 is way out of whack. It actually looks like it's much higher. So that's evidence to suggest that they do in fact like Rob's better. Now this whole process that I've been discussing with you will actually be formalized later. And this is actually known as hypothesis testing, which will totally formalize this process in a future chapter. I'll just kind of get you introduced to the idea now a little bit.